freaks.
Freaks.
So today's tutorial is going to be on this look. Obviously, I'm wearing it right now. It's gonna be on this lovely, bronzy, shiny, glowy, extreme bronze look, glam. In this tutorial, I'm gonna be using both high-end and low-end makeup to meet both audiences' needs. Hopefully, you like this tutorial, and I'll see you at the end. Bye! Hi guys, so I know you must be wondering what the hell happened to my face. Mr. Red Pants came along this month and plagued me with the plague of zits, and this came out of my face. I'm just hoping like all of these things go away. And just like the other day, I was looking at my skin and meaning I actually like my natural skin, and then this happened. So I'm gonna be starting today with La Mer as my moisturizer. And I'm gonna be just putting that across my on my face. Why I really like this cream is that it dries right into your skin. So like if I put a really heavy foundation, it tends to stick onto the foundation and get really moussey. This kind of dries so much on your skin that it just becomes like your skin. So I like how it doesn't play up with dryness or with oiliness. So next I'm gonna go ahead and put my Smashbox Photo Finish Pore Minimizing Primer. Yes, I said it all in one go. And I'm gonna be putting that on my face where I feel my pores are intensified, which is on my cheek area and my chin, my nose. But I'm gonna be putting it on my entire face anyway, so. So now that I've done, I'm gonna go ahead and put my foundation, and today I'm gonna be using Clinique's Even Better Foundation, and this is in the number 06 called Honey. This is a tad bit darker than my skin, really darker than my skin, but I'm gonna be using this because I want to be all bronzed up today. I'm also gonna be using the Real Techniques Multitask Brush, one of my favorite foundation brushes to use. I feel it's so good on the skin and gets things really sunk in. It does a good job. So I'm gonna be putting a second layer as well for my face. This was just the first layer. Now I'm gonna go ahead and set all of my foundation. And I'm gonna be setting my foundation with the icing bronzer. It's a matte bronzer. So I'm just gonna put that all over my face. It's really brown, I know. But we are going for a really bronzed up look today. And this is, I'm gonna just lightly brush it through. I'm gonna be using the Sigma Large Powder F30 brush. Guys, I do apologize if the scar that's on my nose is not disappearing. Off camera, I've tried to conceal it, it's just not going. So I'm sorry. So for my eyeshadow base, I'm gonna be using the Age Rewind by Maybelline in the color Neutralizer. So I'm not gonna be putting too much of that, just a little bit. And I'm gonna be blending that with the e.l.f. Professional Foundation Brush. It's synthetic, so it'll glide on really easily. To set the eyes so that it doesn't crease or anything like that, I want to use the Benai Banana Powder, and I'm going to be using the Sigma Foundation Brush in F60. Make sure you don't set your under eyes because we don't want it to look too cakey underneath right now. So for the highlight off my eye, I'm going to be using the Kat Von D Shade and Light Palette, and I'm going to be using this middle color right here. Next, as a transition color for my crease, I'm going to be using this blush by Maybelline Fit Me in the color Medium Coral, and it's this orangey kind of color. Oh, and I'm going to be using the Tapered Blending Brush by Sigma in E35. Next, for my crease, I'm also going to be using this Contour Kit by Anastasia Beverly Hills as my crease powder. I know it's kind of awkward using a contour kit as eyeshadows, but I like using them. I like the colors in them. So I'm gonna be mixing this orange-ish color with this dark color over here. And I'm using the same brush as I did before. So I'm kind of upset that I cannot find my favorite brush for this step, but I'm gonna be substituting and just using this blending brush by Sigma in E25. And with that, I'm also gonna be using this L'Oreal Color Infallible Eyeshadow in 027 Goldmine. It's really pigmented and it's really pure gold, and that's why I love it. What I'm going to be doing is taking some Fix Plus from MAC, and I'm just going to be light, oh my words, and I'm just going to lightly be spraying this onto my brush just to get the pigment more pigmented. I also will be doing this weird step I've not seen anyone do, and I'm gonna be spraying some of the fixative on my fingers and dabbing the Fix Plus onto my eyelids. I probably should get closer for this. Next, to just diffuse that the tiniest bit, I'm gonna be using this The Bomb Nude Dude Volume 2 eyeshadow. I'm just gonna be putting that on the outer corners and a little bit off the inner corners just to diffuse that gold, because I find it a lot right now. Next, I'm going to be going into my inner corners, and I'm going to be using this Hard Candy palette, using this white shade right in the middle over here. I'm also going to be using this pencil brush by Sigma in the number E30. So I'm just going to rub off the rest onto my hand and just diffuse that glow. Next, I'm going to be working on my eyebrows, and for that I'm going to be using the Essence Eyebrow Designer. So I'm done doing my eyebrows. I think they came out a little too dramatic for my taste, but let's just go with it. Next, I'm going to be just touching up the inner lid of my eyes. I forgot what it's called. Anyways, I'm just going to go on that little I'm gonna be tight lining my eyes, and I'm gonna be using this Lakme Iconic Kajal in the color black. So I'm having a tough time on deciding whether I should put eyeliner or just leave it like this and put falsies, but I think I'll just go with eyeliner. So for eyeliner, I'm gonna be using the Rimmel London Exaggerate Eyeliner, liquid eyeliner in specific. It's in 001 100% black. I was literally holding my breath while doing that. It's so hard to do on camera. Ugh. I am definitely not filming that wing on this eye. I have to get them even, so I'm gonna go off camera, touch it up, and come back. So now that I finished doing my eyeliner on this and that eye, just the wing, I'm gonna also go in with the Lakme that I mentioned before and do the rest of my eyeliner, mainly because I personally do not like putting liquid eyeliner in the inner corners of my eye. So now that I'm done with the eyeliner, finally, I'm going to be moving on to my lashes, and I'm going to be using these lashes by Glossy Makeup, and it is in the name Mayfair, and it's by the girl Natasha Zaki. I personally have met the woman that made these lashes, and she's, I think, from the UK and Egyptian at the same time, and I think she's like friends with another Arabic YouTuber, Maya Ahmed or something like that. Yeah, I think that's her name. I kind of met her at the Dubai Beauty World exhibition at the World Trade Center. And yeah, it was nice. I came to her exhibition and we got this little on sale. And she just recommended her lashes. So I said, hey, I'll just give it a try anyways. They're pretty good. So I'm not tried these ones. I've tried her other lashes. So let's check this out. For the adhesive, I'm going to be using Revlon adhesive. I used to use the Ardell. I know in my How to Put On Lashes video that I used the Ardell, but I stopped. It was giving me this burning sensation every time I put it on my eyes, and it was just not happening for me. I don't even think it's an allergic reaction. It was just, my eyes were on fire, and it felt like someone took mint chewing gum and stuck it on my eye. That's how it felt. So I'm not going to be filming this. If you want to know how to do that, head on to that video. Now that I got my lashes on, I can move on to concealer right now. So today I'm going to be using the Super BB Physicians Formula Concealer under my eyes, and it is in light medium. I'm using this because it has both a yellow and pink base mixed together, so, and it's very lightweight, so I don't want something too heavy on for today. So I'm going to be going in with the e.l.f. Cosmetics Professional Foundation Brush and blending that all in seamlessly into my skin. I'm gonna go in with my Maybelline concealer in the color Sand Sable in the number 20. I now am gonna go with my Benmai Banana Powder, and I'm going to be using the Sigma Foundation F60 brush to just pat it down and yellowify this white contrast right here. Yes, I am aware that I just said yellowify. So now I'm going to be contouring my cheeks just a little bit, not too much, and I'm going to be using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Palette, and I'm going to be using the same brush as I did for the banana powder, as I just said, and I'm going to be mixing these two colors on my cheeks. And then I'm going to take Sigma's large powder F30 brush, and I'm just gonna be dispersing that a bit so there's not too harsh a line on my face. For the next part, I'm gonna be using that same brush, and I'm gonna be using the medium coral as I did for my eyes before, and I'm gonna be using that as blush. I'm choosing this orange color because we want this look to be a little bronzed up, and so I feel pink would kind of tone that down, whereas orange will bring that out. This also is a formula that has more of a little specks of shiny glitter in it, but it's so fine, but it leaves that nice radiant glow on your face. I then am going to be putting some of that onto the tip of my nose, my chin, and a little bit of what's left on the sides of my forehead. Now I'm going to focus on the highlight, which is going to amp up this whole entire bronze look. So I'm going to be using this icing bronzer. It has many layers of bronzer colors in one. And I'm going to be using this one right here with a little bit mix of that yellow. I'm also going to be using the Foundation F60 brush by Sigma. Now I know this is a little too harsh, so what I'm going to do is that I'm going to take that large brush and just blend it in a bit. I'm going to take some of the highlighter and put it on the rest of my face, which is the top of my cupid's bow, the top of my nose, and a little bit on my forehead, like I did in my strobing video. If you want more deets on that, go check out my strobing video. I'll link it down below. So now that we're done with that, I'm just going to be doing the under eye eyeshadow and touching it up with that nude The Balm eyeshadow. I'm going to be using the eye shading E55 Sigma brush. And I'm going to be retouching the inner corners of my eyes with that white shadow from the Hard Candy. I now am going to take the Maybelline New York Lash Sensational Mascara. I have been loving this. No complaints whatsoever. This is on my favorite list of mascaras, but I love it, and I'm going to use it right now on my lower lashes. I don't want to put too much. I'm just going to put very little so that it doesn't overpower the gold and the bronze look of this look, if that makes any sense. Now I'm going to go on to lipstick. So for my lipstick, I'm going to be using two colors in combination. One is going to be Clinique. It's a coral color and it is in CS26. And I'm going to be mixing it with MAC Sis. I just hope that it comes out to be a good combination because I'm trying to be all fancy right now. I've never tried this before, so I really hope this works. You know what's really freaking me out? My clothes over there are forming a shape of a human face, so every time I look into doing my makeup into the mirror, it's like my peripheral vision is forming a face looking right at me while I'm filming, and it's just freaking me out. This is the first time I've tried a coral color by itself. It's kind of new to see it orange on my skin. I'm gonna go into the MAC Sis to diffuse that a little bit. Okay, the MAC Sis did diffuse it, but it didn't get to the color that I want. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mix a little foundation with it and see where the color takes me. So I do not know if this is a nice color right now, but I do not judge until I put my lip liner. So for my lip liner, I'm going to be using this NYX lip liner pencil, and it is in the color. I do not know. Oh, it is 818 dark brown. So now I'm going to be just lining my lips. So I took some tissue and I just dabbed my lips to just mattify it so that the color of the NYX can show through. It was just a little too thick before, so the lipstick got on the lip pencil instead of the lip pencil getting on my lips. I'm just going to be blending that with my finger. This was a little out of my comfort zone, but I actually like it. Interesting. I like it. I'm just gonna be re-putting that highlighter on the Cupid's bow and retouching it. Putting just a smidge in the center of my lips. I swear it looks like a face is staring at me, it's so freaky. So basically I just touched up the lip liner on top with my Hover Lip Pencil by MAC. So off camera I just went a tad bit and contoured my nose just a little bit, not so much. So just when you think that we are done, we're not. So basically what I was going to say was that, remember I told you I'm wearing black and it's for a reason? Well, now comes the time I tell you. So I'm gonna be using this glow by Hard Candy. It's a body glow. I love it. And it is called Hard Candy Glow All The Way, infused with 24 karat gold, Glamazon bronze, face and body luminizer. So I know this looks like a lot, but I'm taking literally that much and just slapping it on my chest. So what I'm gonna do is just massage that in. Okay, I did put a lot. What's wrong with me? Go all the way into my neck. I was going to wear white for this tutorial, but then I said, not gonna happen. Not going to happen right today. As you can see, it's already gotten my shirt. Imagine what a tragedy it would be if I was wearing white. That would just be a tragedy. I just know it. So just add and stack as much as you want. As you can see now, it's literally glowing. Like, I don't know if you can see. It's just so funny. And it really just gives you this glow. Like, can you not see? These are my collarbones are glowing. So good. I'm just gonna go a little bit up into the neck, into the ears. Yeah, just in case I didn't put foundation there. If you saw my leg right now and what I did with half of the product that I first put on my chest, you'd really laugh. But one thing I do have to say about the eyelashes, the lash band is so noticeable, and that's what annoys me in most eyelashes, is when the lash is kind of gray while your eyeliner is black. So I went in and I touched it up with the Rimmel eyeliner, but I just hate doing that. I wish I found lashes that naturally just look black on you. You don't have to line them, and I have found those lashes before. I just don't have them, unfortunately, right now. So that's my only complaint. Other than that, I think the lashes look fantastic. And then last but not least, spray everything with MAC Fix Spray. This just intensifies the glow. So if you have any glow and it's looking powdery, but this mixed in it as a spray, it totally makes it sink and melt into your skin and marries them together. So just use that, and that's a tip. So this is the finished look and the final look. And this is the ultimate bronze. Yeah, as you can see, my highlighter is totally distracting me. It can stop traffic. Basically, I wanted to keep this tutorial. What is up with ET finger, ET fingers. Basically, I wanted to keep this tutorial really simple, really easy. I do have some high-end products in this tutorial, I know. But I've also mixed it up with some low-end products as well.
Balancing, you're balancing.
I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you found it nice and easy. I'm really displeased that my shirt is currently dirty. Ooh. And I hope you liked it. It's very glamorous, glammy. Don't forget to tag me if you do this. If you do this tutorial. Don't forget to like, thumbs up, share, subscribe. Yeah, and I shall see you slay. Also, don't forget to follow me on my other social accounts, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Snapchat. Guys, I'm on that thing 24/7. Be on it. Follow me. Add me. I am called Abigail Kristen. Yeah, just like my YouTube page. Over there, basically, I just post things about my daily life. Food I eat, the makeup I bought, anything new. I post makeup looks, sometimes natural looks when I'm totally looking not like this. Yeah, some funny ones too that can make you probably make your day. So follow me over there and hope to see new people coming on. That middle, ooh. And then I'm gonna be putting some, oh my god, what's this?
Brick.
Literally how much water I drink. Like, I saw this bottle and I'm like, this is gonna be my water bottle. Sometimes the cloud comes over and sometimes they just go separate and together. Really played with my ISO, back to human form, and then got into alien form, and it was all over the place. That's what it's all